I've been waiting for this film for over a decade. And I'm serious, I have. I took about an hour before I started recording to find this photo of me in my first and only Avatar shirt back in 2009. Jesus, look at me. I look nothing like that anymore. And the funny thing is that this shirt is now being sold for $50 and up on eBay. Like, what the hell? That's how rare this shirt is. I wish I still had it. I could remember it like it was yesterday. Walking into the theater, seeing all the movie posters for the new films out that year. There was Jennifer's Body, Halloween 2, the Friday the 13th reboot that didn't even go anywhere. And then one of the greatest comic book movies ever created, X-Men Origin Wolverine. What a huge pile of dog crap that movie was. But I was there to see Avatar. My dad and my mom took me out to see it that morning. We were mind blown. That entire movie. We didn't even know what to expect. We just knew it was James Cameron. We just knew it was the director of Terminator Judgment Day. We just knew it was the director of Titanic. So we knew it was going to be some epic thing. Judgment Day is one of my favorite action flicks of all time. So I was expecting so much going into this movie, and I got more than that. Avatar is a film that I hold dearly in my heart. It's a film that brought me and my family closer together into loving films mutually. And so this film is super special to me. It's one of the films when I think back to being a child, being 10 years old back when this movie came out. This movie makes me so happy that it just exists. I remember when this movie came out on Blu-ray, I begged my dad to buy it for me. Here's a picture of it now. I still have it all the way from, it's either 2009 or 2010 the Blu-ray came out. I do the research if you want, but one of those years is when I begged my dad to buy this for me. And I remember rushing upstairs, going to our cheap ass living room with no speakers, nothing. It was pretty booty. And I put the disc in and I skipped to the ending fight because I just wanted to rewatch the ending fight again. Like, I was going to rewatch the movie, but the ending fight is so awesome and it still holds up to this day. So going into Avatar: The Way of Water, you know I had high expectations. You know I was ready to go back into James Cameron world, but I always remember, you never bet against James Cameron. Over a decade later, I can honestly say that this movie blew me away. It blew me all the way back to 2009.
That's what she said.
I was back to being that 10-year-old kid. Watching this movie felt like sitting in the theater for the first time. You know, grabbing your bowl of popcorn, stuffing your face, and just being blown away by everything you're seeing on the screen. It felt like going to the beach for the first time and feeling the waves hit your body.
I see you don't have a lifeguard here at your beach.
I'm not at the beach, this is a bathtub.
It felt like you were flying. Kind of how Woody and Buzz were flying to Andy at the end of Toy Story 1 to meet up with him, and it was such a happy moment. And I'm off topic, but you get it. It is an amazing feeling when you're watching this movie. Avatar: The Way of Water is mesmerizing. This film blows your mind on a technical standpoint. This is James Cameron's technical masterpiece in cinema. Like, it's just so crazy how the live action mixes with the CGI and the action, the special effects, the VFX, all that stuff. It's so crazy. When you look at other movies such as Marvel films or DC films or other big blockbusters, when they kind of incorporate CGI and it kind of looks messy, but this whole movie is CGI, 3.5 hours or 3 hours and 10 minutes actually, but it's just insane. And on top of that, I love the story. I love seeing Jake Sully and Natiri back. I love Sam Worthington and Zoe Saldana. I think they're some of the best actors out right now. And it's nice to actually see Sam Worthington back. I haven't seen Sam Worthington since Hacksaw Ridge. That was so many years ago. And so it's super cool to see him on the front of a movie now. And Zoe Saldana is always killing it in everything she does, even as Gamora in the Guardians films, and now back as Natiri in Avatar 2 all these years later. Does a phenomenal job. But the interesting thing about this movie is that they started a family and they have kids. So the main focus of this film is their children and kind of what they're doing and experiencing throughout this time. Now, there is actors that you may recognize their voices. Stephen Lang is back. Sigourney Weaver is back. Now, I did not know why they were back. I didn't know what characters they were playing, what their plot was in the movie. So I'm not going to spoil anything for you personally. I went in kind of blind. I only saw the first teaser trailer where there was like no dialogue until the end when Jake is like, our family is our fortress. But that was really the last thing I saw. So I didn't see any other trailers. So I was going in blind, really. And so most of the plot points I had not known. So I was pretty surprised when I saw some of these reoccurring characters here. Overall, this film did blow me away. Does it have a simple story? Yes, but that's what James Cameron is good at. He's good at putting a simple story of family, revenge, a lot of the family drama, all that good stuff, on top of this huge sci-fi epic where there's Na'vi, there's avatars, sky people, spaceship, explosion, water, everything. And there is a lot of water in this movie, so get ready for a lot of water scenes. Like, everyone is underwater this whole time. They actually even filmed the movie underwater in motion cap suits, and the actors had to hold their breaths like throughout the whole time. That is pretty, pretty cool. Overall, Avatar The Way of Water is one of the best films of the year. I'm kind of having trouble picking a top three because I do still think Top Gun Maverick is one of my favorites, but Avatar 2 is kind of kicking it, especially because I am kind of biased because I did love the first Avatar and now I'm loving this one. So it's just so much fun to me. One thing I was watching this and kind of thinking about is, where did the magic go in cinema? One thing I always question myself over these years is, a lot of movies weren't making me feel like they used to, weren't making me as excited as they used to. And when I got to see Avatar The Way of Water, I felt like that 10-year-old kid back in 2009 sitting in that theater in Cinemark and feeling that emotion, feeling that excitement, feeling the no priorities, feeling that I don't have any worries. I felt like that sitting in this theater, and that really enhanced the moment for me, because I do think magic in movies is still there. It's just you need the right people to do it, and I think James Cameron is one of those. I think throughout 2022 we have had bangers coming out and people that know how to bring the magic back to the movies. Top Gun, Batman, Everything Everywhere All at Once, The Black Phone, Wakanda Forever, and movies like Avatar 2 are movies that are bringing the magic back to movies, the magic back to things we watch. Even Spider-Man No Way Home, that came out last December, but that is a movie that brought everyone back to 2001 when Tobey was Spider-Man. And then later on when Andrew was Spider-Man, and it was just so awesome to see these things bring us back to our childhoods, bring us back to a time that we didn't have any worries. And I really appreciated Avatar 2 for being a part of bringing me back to a time that I love so dearly. Guys, I can talk about Avatar 2 for hours and hours and how much I loved it and blah, 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 blah. Just go see the damn movie. You got my recommendation. I think it's awesome. You're going to think it's awesome too. You will not regret it. It is the best 3 hours in a theater that I've had in a long time. So definitely go out to see it. I saw this like in a bunch of comment sections and I thought it was pretty deep. So I'm going to end the video by saying this. The Way of Water has no beginning and no end. Our hearts beat in the womb of the world. Water connects all things, life to death and darkness to light. The sea gives and the sea takes. My name is Benito Donato. Thanks for tuning into this video. Stay tuned to many more. Happy holidays. Have a great rest of your day.